Hey everyone, in this video, we're going to be talking about the intensity of radiation. Just as a precursor to this video, if you missed the previous video on solid angles, I recommend that you check out that video first, and I will leave a link in the description below for you to do so. So what is the intensity of radiation? Well, previously, we were discussing the emission from a black and gray body in all directions. However, we may also want to know how much of that total emission hits a certain object, for example. Well, that is what the intensity of radiation is. Intensity can be defined as the magnitude of a given quantity, so energy, over the area of contact. And just like we did in the black body videos for emissivity, we can find the monochromatic or spectral intensity, which is the intensity created by a single wavelength, or the total intensity of radiation, which is the total radiation of all wavelengths that are hitting a given surface. In order to find the intensity of radiation, that is to say, the energy per meter squared hitting a surface, we need the use of solid angles, which is why it was covered in the previous video. So, in summary, imagine that we have some infinitesimally small surface generating energy, and we want to know how much of that energy is going to hit the surface of interest. The units of the intensity of radiation are kilowatts per meter squared per wavelength, which is denoted in microns, because this is our typical size range for wavelengths. Per steradians, which is the units of our solid angle, which we talked about in the previous video. Now, we can state a few facts that we know about black bodies. We know that a black body will emit radiation of all wavelengths in all directions. Therefore, the intensity of radiation in phi and theta directions do not matter, and spatially it doesn't matter as well. Therefore, the only things affecting the spectral black body intensity is the wavelength of interest and the temperature. For this, I will leave a link in the description below for a full derivation. However, the intensity of a black body normal to a given surface and in a vacuum environment can be written as Planck's distribution law, which I have written here, divided by pi. However, what if our area of interest is not simply normal to the radiation surface? Well, then we need to implement what is called Lambert's cosine law. So, this diagram here should make this more clear. We can find the intensity of radiation in any direction, as it will be proportional to the cosine of the angle of interest. So, we represent this mathematically as the emissive power of our black body times the cosine of our angle over pi. Alright, so now we have an idea how to find the intensity of radiation. That is, the energy emitted from our black body that will hit and thereby interact with a given surface. So, another thing of particular interest to us is how much energy is transmitted from surface 1 here to surface 2. Well, if you remember from our previous solid angle video, the differential solid angle to our point in space is equal to the differential area over the radius squared. Then we can use what is called the inverse square law, which states that a physical quantity is inversely proportional to the square of the distance from the source, which is basically saying if we begin at a source and take one step, one radius away from that source, our area covered will be equal to one radius. However, if we take two radius steps away from our source, our area covered is now going to be r squared. So, every step from our source, we are expanding at r to the power of r steps away. So, we can write that the differential area we are going to hit is equal to the radius squared times the differential solid angle. So, the amount of radiation that is generated from our small finite surface area, which we will call A finite, is the intensity of radiation times the small finite area, times the differential solid angle normal to the surface. If your point of interest is not normal, then you use Lambert's cosine law, and it becomes the following. Lastly, note that this is only valid for diffuse radiation. If you're unsure what that means, I recommend you check out the other video linked in the description below. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of what the intensity of radiation is and how we can find it. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our Patreon page to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.